New at 6, the governor's office asked pardon applicants not to appear at their own hearings in order to speed up the process. NBC 15's Zach Schultz tells us why today was the first and last pardon hearing without any testimony.
The Pardon Advisory Board reviewed the files of 27 people today, all in just under 2 hours. Normally, it would take an entire day to hear 27 people explain why their old misdemeanor crimes should be pardoned by the governor. But these people were asked to waive their right to appear in person by Susan Crawford, the chair of the board and legal counsel to Governor Doyle.
For today's meeting, the applicants have all agreed to be heard on the basis of their written materials rather than appearing in person before the board.
I would just like to restate my objection to proceeding without having the applicants here to hear from them.
Cindy O'Donnell says that request may have violated the executive order that created the board. But even if it didn't, it certainly doomed the candidates on today's list.
I voted to deny grants on all 27.
O'Donnell is an administrator in the Department of Justice and says some people didn't deserve pardons because of the seriousness of their crimes or the objections of the prosecutor, but says she couldn't vote for any pardons without interviewing the person.
I've reviewed case files and thought, boy, this doesn't, you know, look like a strong case. And the applicant could come in and really does a nice job of explaining not only why they committed the criminal conduct, but how they've changed their lives since then.
Crawford would not say why she asked people to waive their right to appear, and neither would the governor's office.
A spokesman for Governor Doyle was quite vague today, first saying people were playing political games, but then refusing to clarify who he was referring to or what these political games may be.
I don't want to get into a discrepancy, some argument that's just a bunch of political games.
O'Donnell says she was told the waiver was designed to cram an all-day process into a two-hour review, but says these candidates deserved better.
This wasn't political for me. This was about following the rule of law.
Zach Schultz, NBC 15 News.
Following the meeting, O'Donnell says he was promised no one would be asked to waive their right to appear in future pardon hearings. We want to clarify that even though O'Donnell says she voted no on all 27 applicants, there are 6 other members of the board, and we don't know how they voted. Governor Doyle has the right to pardon anyone, no matter what the advisory board recommends.